right, and we have two of them. So first one will be the chi squared left, which is very important. The second one will be chi squared right. So how are we going to find it? Remember, it says the area represents the what? To the right of the critical value, right? So for example, 95% confidence level, that corresponds to what? 0.95 in the middle. Agree? So what's the area in the tails? This will be what? 0.025, and so is this one. Now, to find the critical value, we have two of them. Remember, like the Z, right? We had two critical values. One is on the left, one is on the right. Now, we're going to locate this in the what? In the top row, which is right here. Agree? And with the N equals to 25, so what's the degrees of freedom? 24. So first we're going to find the 24, degrees of freedom 24, and then read the what? This was this row, right? So chi squared right will be 39.364. If I want to find chi squared left, this is not symmetric. You cannot just simply say, oh, that's a negative, because there is no negative, right? So what we're going to do is, see, remember, the property said, always look at the what? The right areas and read the what? The critical value. So what is the right area to the right of the critical value on this one? So if this is 2.5%, this is 2.5%, what's the area to the right of the critical value?
97.5.
Yeah, 97.5. So you always look for the what? The area, see, 95% plus 2.5, you get 0.975. So locate that in the table and read the Z, read the chi-squared left. So what is that? This is the row we're going to look for, agree? So what is that? We go to what? The 24, and we read the critical value, which is to the left. So which was what? So here, and what is that? I got 24 degrees of freedom. It's going to be what? 12.401. So we have two critical values. That corresponds to what? 95% confidence level with that degrees of freedom.
Where did you get the degrees of freedom?